Today we're talking about jobs, because the recent job reports came out, and I wouldn't say things are good. Because that would be like shrugging off winning the lottery. Things are looking really, really good, to the point where I'm almost suspicious someone made a mistake and forgot a decimal point or something. I, again, don't want to understate this, because these results are so good we're starting to see headlines like, "How low can unemployment go? Economists keep getting that answer wrong." It's so crazy right now that according to NBC, an entity that's about as likely to congratulate Trump on an accomplishment as the Imam of Iran, recently said there are more jobs than people out of work, something the American economy has never experienced before. Unfortunately, the vast majority of the news right now is more focused on the fact that Roseanne Barr is unemployed than the fact that our nation is literally hitting unprecedented employment levels. Alright, so if you haven't noticed yet, I'm pleased to announce that this is probably going to be a happy episode, where we pop some champagne, just put our legs up on this nice set of laurels we happen to be sitting on, and figure out how we got here. So first, what was this job report?
There is great news about the U.S. economy. Just over an hour ago, the Labor Department reporting 223,000 jobs were added last month. That is better than economists expected. The unemployment rate also fell 0.1% to 3.8%. That ties for the lowest rate in half a century.
What the hell am I doing here talking to you guys? I have to update the address on my resume ASAP. Alright, so let's get into the weeds on this a little bit. Because the largest problem that people seem to be worried about is that there aren't enough people to fill all of these jobs. So, thank God we didn't finish building that wall yet. Alright, so what is up with this jobs report? Well, first off, here's maybe the first fun fact that's actually fun on this show. When the recession hit, we lost 8.7 million jobs. I know, not fun yet, but wait for it. Because since the recession, we've made 18.9 million jobs. What? That's more than two times as many jobs as we lost. What does that mean though? Because jobs could mean a lot of things. It's like when your mom sets you up on a blind date and will only tell you that it's with a girl. You need a little more information before you start really jumping for joy. Luckily, a major part of the Bureau of Labor Statistics publishing a report is the fact that anyone can read it. So I dug right in. Our two biggest growing industries are construction and retail, which, despite the fact that we aren't hiring 100,000 additional rocket scientists this quarter, is a good sign for the economy, because these jobs indicate long-term optimism by showing people are building and buying. We also had similar growth in the professional and business services, which, okay, can you get any more generic sounding than that? Sounds like Michael Cohen's Essential Consultants LLC was hiring. I don't weight that rise as high though, because it's half temp work, and counting temp work in your labor statistics is like including proficient in Microsoft Word on your resume. Sure, it's a thing, but it really shouldn't be changing anyone's mind. On the other hand, the trend that jumped out to me was a change in the durations of unemployment. Now, every single number on here should widen the smile on your face a little bit more. We're seeing massive declines in long and medium term unemployment rates, which means we're actually bringing new people back into the workplace. Now, before I go on, quick self high five, because well, we deserve it. Alright, back to the numbers again. What is up with that less than 5 weeks unemployment? Well, that doesn't look good. That's a pretty large change that, for whatever reason, has no impact on longer term employment. So what is going on there? Well, I couldn't find any articles on it, because every time you try to research short term unemployment, you get inundated with articles from 2010 talking about the big problem of rising long term unemployment. A problem which is being solved right before our eyes. If you look a little deeper in the report though, I think you'll find an answer, because the highest and growing reason for unemployment last quarter was job leavers, meaning that a worker left his job to presumably work somewhere better. And if that's not the best reason to have a continued unemployment rate, I don't know what is. So as you can tell, our economy is currently doing about as well as a SimCity with all of the cheats turned on. But why? Well, we've gone through an unprecedented period of 92-month straight job growth. That's 7 years and 8 months without a single month of losing more jobs than were created. We should be talking about this every day on the news. This is awesome. If I had an air horn, I'd probably have blown out the speaker by now. So let's see what happened this last 7 years and 8 months. First, this isn't the number of jobs in the economy. It's the number of jobs added to the economy. So when the line slopes downward, it's not losing jobs, instead just gaining fewer jobs. Alright, so for a while, it's your standard rise and fall of employment increases, which most economists predicted. But then something strange happened recently. The employment numbers apparently suddenly watched Rocky and got inspired in the second wind. What most economists agree was supposed to happen was the rate of job creation would continue to fall as companies recovered and the pool of available workers dried up. But something happened in 2017 to rally the markets. Well, two things, actually.
We've got a tax cut, and now we've overlaid on that a budget explosion. Is that what we've done, two back-to-back?
Yes, in 2017, a cocktail of tax cuts and huge government spending increases pumped that growth back into the right direction. Now, these actions were controversial, as you can probably tell by the tone of that guy who managed to squeeze into those glasses he just bought at Harry Potter World. And I've covered these controversies in the past, but I'm here today to talk employment. So the markets have re-rallied and we're now entering into uncharted territories. Now to the party poopers, the economists who frankly are freaking out a little bit. Nobody knew these numbers could go this low. In fact, the Federal Reserve predictions for this economy were way too pessimistic. Their estimates are in red, while the reality is in blue. Wow, the Fed really doesn't seem to have faith in throwing tons of money at the problem until it fixes itself. So what's the problem? Well, since the 1960s, economists have had this idea of an ideal unemployment rate. And because economists are soulless, that number isn't zero. The idea is that there's a rate of unemployment somewhere in the range of 5-6% that's essential in order for the economy to function smoothly. The idea is that you need to keep a base number of people in the population in abject poverty to slow down spending and maintain neutral inflation rates. Wow, I think my soul just died a little bit. To go into a little more detail, when you have more jobs than workers, wages go up across the board. And when wages go up, people get more money. And when people get more money, prices go up because they can spend more money. And then you have inflation. Wow, you know, when you put it that way, the whole system seems pretty messed up. For regular listeners, this would be classified as an increase in the velocity of money causing inflation. Alright, so that was the prevailing theory for the longest time. But several times unemployment has dipped below 4%, and rather than a monetary apocalypse, we just saw people become happier. So what happened? Well, in a post-recession world, people are starting to call BS on that theory, which has a few problems. The first problem with this rate is that nobody can determine it with any accuracy. When economists say it's 5 or 6%, they're basically guessing. Wow, that inspires so much confidence. So why is the ideal unemployment rate 5%? Well, 5's a really great number. It's half of 10 and it's just simple, you know? It's pretty. Don't think about it. If an economist told you to jump off a bridge, would you? Okay, furthermore, at the end of Obama's term, his Council of Economic Advisors pretty much wrote a 435-page book that I'm yet to read the entirety of. And it is covered in excruciating detail of the coefficient changes of and you stop listening. I vowed to never read the word coefficient again once I graduated with an economics degree. Anyways, basically, and I'm gonna translate the text as it appears in the novel to non-stroke-inducing language. We looked at the impact of unemployment on inflation over the last 20 years, and we don't need to come up with a more precise natural rate of unemployment, because turns out, it doesn't really have an impact. If we can pull off this low rate of unemployment without tipping the inflation scales, this could be amazing for workers. Because lower unemployment increases bargaining power, therefore increasing wages. And, you know, people tend to like having jobs. We are already seeing wages go up, although, truth be told, not as much as some people would like to see. But until next time, get a job! And that's all I have to say about that. Hello, YouTube. If you want to support nonpartisan comedic reporting, please subscribe to my channel and like below. Thank you for watching.